Center for Poverty Analysis, in short CEPA, a think tank based in Colombo. We are into three things, research, policy influencing, and advisory. CEPA in its first 9 years was primarily a consultancy or applied research organization, not so much a policy oriented think tank. Due to various reasons, CEPA was trying to reinvent a role for itself. At the same time, when TTA was also looking for partners in Sri Lanka, so we became part of a think tank community, and by virtue of that, we also became, you know, a think tank gradually, which is very different from what we used to do. Research still remains to be the foundation. So one cutting edge project that we had under the banner of what we call reimagining development was supported by TTI, and that gave us an opportunity to revisit, challenge, and also transform the whole discussion, the discourse on development. So we could question the current paradigm, status quo, and also come up with creative, insightful ideas. So this whole project, which had different aspects, idea generation, and also dialogues with policy communities and also practitioners, was entirely supported and sponsored by the Think Tank Initiative. As you know, CEPA, P stands for poverty, so it's our focus. A year back, the president wanted to announce the last year as the year of poverty alleviation. And the presidential secretariat, the office, requested CEPA to draft a policy paper, which could be used as the foundation document for the president to make the announcement. So this document was also improvised into a bill, which was later turned into an act. So that was one of the happy moments for CEPA, that we could make an impact of that nature. So the culmination of that was the appointment of a presidential committee to decide the vision for Sri Lanka for 2030, and a member of CEPA was also invited to serve on that 30-member commission. So that's one of our areas of policy influencing in the last couple of years, which we think could result in changes in poverty-related work in Sri Lanka.